Hi guys, I am in my laundry room and I am going to share my very simple tips that help me to keep my laundry from becoming overwhelming.
Tip number one, get in the habit of putting dirty laundry in a basket or a hamper. And that way you're not going to have dirty clothes lying around your room. There will be no hangers or wet towels on your bed or the bathroom floor. If you simply teach everyone in the family to hang up their towel or put it in a basket and have a spot for their dirty laundry either in the hallway or a basket in the closet, or if they are a little bit older, teach them to separate their laundry. The laundry isn't going to pile up and take over other rooms of your home.
When my kids were small, under the age of 5, we lived in a different home and we didn't use our back door. And our hallway was kind of small, so there wasn't really a spot to put a hamper or a basket. So we actually had a baby gate right here. It was a different house, but it was sort of set up like this. And my kids would just throw their dirty laundry over the gate into the basket along with their hangers. And they can do this at such a young age. And then just make it part of your routine to separate the laundry. When they get a little bit older and they're able to go down the stairs by themselves, if your laundry room is downstairs, and they're able to learn to separate laundry on their own, you can just have everybody take their hangers and their laundry down to the laundry room and separate it all for you.
Tip number two, separate your laundry daily.
Whether everyone in your family separates their own laundry or you need to do it yourself if your children are too young to do it on their own, definitely separate your laundry every day. It will save you so much time and it won't become overwhelming because you won't have an enormous mountain of laundry to sort through. And if you just do a little bit at a time, make it a habit, it really doesn't take long at all. And with my family separating their own laundry, we just do it. We don't even think about it. So I'm going to show you how I have my laundry separated. So I have a basket for towels. If you don't have room for this, you can definitely just leave your towels on the bathroom hook for a couple days, and then when it's your day to wash the towels, you can just go through and grab them. It just makes it easier the way that our house is set up and the hooks that we have and everything to throw them in the basket after a couple days. So that works for us. I have a basket here for delicate, so I keep my bras in here that I want to hand wash, any sweaters that I want to wash on the delicate cycle, and anything that needs to be hand washed. I have a basket here for whites, or things that you either want to bleach or use a bleach alternative. So my rags that I use for cleaning get tossed in there. I have a light basket, so any light clothes get tossed in there, and then I have a dark basket. Now, you might be wondering, how on earth do I teach my children how to separate laundry? They'll probably mix it up and everything. Now, I will say when you're first teaching them, definitely as you're throwing the laundry in, just make sure there isn't a red shirt in your light laundry or something like that. But what I did, I labeled all of my baskets. So we used to have labels on them. We don't really need them anymore. And, you know, after a while, they get kind of grungy looking. So I took them off because we always keep these baskets in the same spot so everyone knows, you know, that's the dark basket and that's the light basket. And so you can definitely make labels. If your children are old enough to read, you can just spell it right out. You can get as fancy as you want. If you want to teach your kids to separate laundry and they aren't able to read extremely well, you could always draw a little picture of a red shirt, a black pair of pants or something, or socks or a towel, or you could just draw a box with a color. Your children can learn to separate laundry at a very early age. My kids were pretty young, and one of my children is colorblind, and he just goes by the shades, and it saves so much time for me, and everything is all separated.
Tip number three, keep a basket for hangers.
Have a spot for everyone to put their hangers, and that way when you go to hang up laundry, you don't have to search through closets and try to find hangers. They're not all tangled in with the clothes or lying on the floor or anything. We just have this basket here and everyone puts their hangers in there, and it just makes it easier when I have to hang up laundry.
Tip number four, get in the habit of doing one load of laundry every day.
If you just throw your laundry in the morning, even if you are a working mom or a very busy person, if you just throw your laundry in while you're getting ready and then throw it in the dryer or hang up your laundry, it won't even really feel like you have a ton of laundry because you're just doing one load. It's so simple, but if you let it build up, you have to be around for a few hours to switch out the laundry and hang it up and fold it and everything. If you just do one load a day, I'm telling you, it just saves so much time and frustration, and you won't feel overwhelmed with a giant pile of laundry. So for my laundry today, I am going to wash a basket of towels, and I went and grabbed the hand towels, and I usually just wash those when I'm doing a load of towels, and that way, we have fresh hand towels every couple days.
Tip number five, keep up with things that need to be hand washed.
I also hand wash anything that needs to be hand washed on a daily basis. And that might seem like, oh, what a waste of time, but it really only takes a minute to hand wash a shirt. But if you have a whole pile of them, I know for me, I don't really like to hand wash things. And if I have like six or seven sweaters and shirts and bras that I need to hand wash, it's like, ugh. But if I just have one, it only takes me like a minute to do. So I just do it as I'm throwing in laundry and I'm down here anyway. I just, keep up with it instead of letting it pile up. I know my laundry room is not the prettiest room in the whole world, but we live in an older home and this is sort of what you have for a laundry room in an older home. When I hand wash my laundry, I hang it up over my wash tub here so that it can drip down. I'm sure a lot of you probably do that. The only thing you need to be careful of is if you use bleach and you hang it over your wash tub and the washer sprays into your wash tub, it can splatter bleach on, say, your nice sweater that you hand wash or something. So you might want to be careful about that. All of the scratching that you probably heard in the background of my video is this guy, one of our tortoises. He was right behind me trying to get out. So I'm going to let him out and roam around while I finish recording the rest of this video.
Tip number six, don't leave your wet laundry in the washer. Set a timer if you need to.
Remember to put your laundry in the dryer, and that way you aren't rewashing things and everything. If it becomes a habit to do one load a day, you generally won't forget. But if you're starting a new habit, you could even set a little timer on your phone for like 20 or 30 minutes just so you remember to go down and put it in the dryer or hang it up.
Tip number seven, save money by hanging up laundry to dry.
We have this rod here. It was here when we moved, and it's great to hang up laundry because my furnace is over there, so it's blowing warm air in the winter and it dries all of my laundry. It saves us money. Plus, we are all tall and I don't want to shrink our clothes. So I just take all of our laundry out, like shirts and pants and things. I usually put them in the dryer for about 10 minutes to get the wrinkles out. We still iron some things, but this just helps so it's not a big, wrinkled, dripping, wet mess hanging up here. So I hang all of our stuff as much as I can to dry.
Tip number eight, keep dish towels in a bucket with vinegar and water until you are ready to wash them.
This guy is coming after my toes. He thinks they're food, I think. I'm having quite the time trying to record this. I'm just keeping this in here to keep it real. So anyway, I have another tip for you. I have a bucket here next to my wash tub that I keep my dish rags in. And I've mentioned this before in other videos, but in case you're newer and haven't happened to watch those, I put water and vinegar in here with my dish rags because they don't get washed every single day. And you know how dish rags are, they're wet and you use them to wipe up food. And even though you rinse them, they can start to smell pretty gross. So I just keep them in there with some vinegar and that kind of freshens them up a little bit. And then once I get ready to wash everything, I just throw it right in the washer.
Tip number nine, fold each load of laundry once it is done drying.
Fold your laundry when it's done in the dryer So you can just have it as part of your routine, but I think it's so nice to just fold one load of laundry at a time instead of letting it build up and then you have that pile of laundry. Also, I find it best to just fold it right on top of the dryer. This is a good reason to keep the top of your dryer nice and clean, and I do wipe this off as part of my cleaning routine. But I like this because if we throw our laundry in a basket and then drag it into the living room to watch TV or watch something on our iPad, you know, it just gets taken to another spot and then we have to put it away and it just takes longer. So I just like to fold it right on top of my dryer and then put it away. And if you just do one load of laundry at a time, it really doesn't take very long to fold it. I mean, this is probably only going to take me about 3 minutes. If you are like me and you hang up your laundry to dry, just get in the habit of taking it down every morning when you start your new load of laundry. Just come over and take all of your laundry down and put it away, and that way you'll have a spot for it once your load of laundry is done for that day.
And my last tip for you, tip number 10, only iron clothes for the next day instead of a giant pile.
As far as ironing goes, we usually just iron our clothes the night before we wear them because they tend to get wrinkly in our closets. We don't have enormous walk-in closets or anything. So if we iron something and then put it in our closet, it tends to get really wrinkled. Also, I don't like to have a huge stack of things to iron. Ironing definitely isn't my favorite thing to do. So usually we will pick out our clothes the night before and then just iron if we, you know, need a shirt ironed, and that really helps to have your clothes all ready for the next day, as well as not having an enormous stack of, you know, shirts to iron. So that just really works out for us. Reagan, you can go back in your cage now. I hope you enjoyed this laundry video and I hope it gave you some good ideas. Thank you so much for watching.